Hi again, it's Jason from Fraser Valley Rose Farm. And what if I were to tell you that plants have cheat codes? Like if you clicked this one over here, it would make them come out of dormancy and grow straight upwards. Or if you clicked this other one, it would force them to branch or ripen their fruit. Well, of course, plants do regulate themselves this way with plant growth hormones. And whether you know it or not, you or a grower on your behalf is already manipulating these plant growth regulators. So let's talk about the five most commonly and best understood types of plant growth regulators and how they are being manipulated to make your plants do what you want them to do. The first of the five secret controls I'm going to talk about today is called gibberellic acid. I also call it the go hormone because it induces plants to come out of dormancy. If they're a seed that's in dormancy or if they're a plant that's been in the cold and storage like these roses and in dormancy, this gibberellic acid would be what tells them to start growth again and begin stretching upwards. Now, obviously you don't always want plants to stretch, and if you apply gibberellic acid in too large amount, you'll get really, really super long shoots, which is undesirable, but this is kind of a cool one for breaking dormancy. And also it is, of the five, the easiest for the home gardener to obtain, and a lot of people experiment with using this to break dormancy in seeds. So the second one I want to talk about is called auxins, and if gibberellic acid told the plant to grow or to go, this one tries to tell the plant where to grow, specifically upwards, straight, and downwards to the roots. So imagine a plant like this one here, a straight up tree that wants to maintain that growing tip and put all its energy into going straight up. That's an auxin related reaction, and also it is related to root development, and so auxins are the rooting hormone. The third hormone I want to talk about is cytokinins, and if the auxins tried to say go straight up or straight down, the cytokinins say go side to side, or they're the branching hormone. So like if you were to pinch a young seedling, like a lavender seedling, then it forces the branching and development of additional side branches. So this one has been pinched to try to induce a higher level of cytokinins in relation to auxins, so it doesn't grow straight upwards, it grows bushy and outwards like that. And so that's what the cytokinins are used for. The fourth commonly manipulated hormone is the stop hormone, or abscisic acid, exactly the opposite of gibberellic acid. This is the one that induces and enforces dormancy on plants and is their stress reaction. So my hydrangeas here are all currently dormant, and they should be because there's still a strong risk of deep cold. And in fact, if they're trying to get hardiness into citrus fruit, they're trying to make them more dormant and more ready for cold weather, they will spray them with abscisic acid. They use it for other dormancy related treatments as well. The fifth and final of these hormones I want to talk about is called ethylene, and the other four are produced and held within the tissues of the plants. This one is released as a gas. So this is the famously don't put an apple with your bananas hormone, because the apple will release ethylene, the bananas will absorb it, and then the bananas will ripen prematurely. So for this reason, fruit processors take great care to take apples, pears, and passion fruit and keep them away from things like bananas or say cauliflowers or cabbage that will induce ripening. It's also something that cut flower growers will try to inhibit or remove from the environment so that their flowers have a longer vase life. Okay, now we get to the fun part is, how is it that growers and gardeners are using these plant growth hormones to manipulate their plants? And some of the best and most masterful use of this comes from the tree fruit industry, or orchards, where at certain times during the year and all timed perfectly, they may apply a gibberellin inhibitor to improve stocky branches or reduce the stretch. At other times, they may apply more gibberellin and more cytokinin to improve fruit shape and size. They may apply auxins to make the plants drop excess fruit, and they may apply ethylene to prematurely ripen the fruit. So they play these fruit trees like a fiddle. Now, as a perennial grower for many years, the most common that I used was a gibberellin inhibitor to make your plants more stocky. So if a perennial grew to size, then you would apply the gibberellin inhibitor to keep them at that marketable size for a longer period of time and to keep them squat and sturdy during shipping. Now, the other thing I might have applied at from time to time is cytokinins to improve branching, because you can get super basal branching with cytokinins. And I may have also applied ethylene in an unexpected way to delay the flowering, because if it's applied during early stages of flowering, it may actually hold back the flowering. So if you had a big crop of, say, something like phlox, you might apply it to half the crop so that you could stage out the flowering for marketing over a longer period. As an amateur grower or a home-based gardener, it may seem a little bit far-fetched to be spraying your plants with a bunch of sprays to either boost or inhibit the effects of these plant growth hormones, but don't fool yourself, you're actually already manipulating your plants using their hormones. You just do it a little bit indirectly through conditions like heat and light, or by pinching the plant. When you pinch the plant, you're disrupting that balance between the auxins and the cytokinins, and you're inducing more branching. Or when you deadhead, what you're doing is you're stopping the plant from its regular flowering and ripening cycle, and you're pushing it back into the cytokinins for branching and the gibberellins to do new shoots for more fruiting and shoots. Knowing that your dormancy is also related to cold. So if you're doing seed treatments based on leaving them in the fridge for stratification, what you're doing is you're breaking down those abscisic acids inside the seeds and eventually allowing the gibberellins to overtake it. So you're already doing this. And if you want to have a brief primer on how to manipulate conditions, have a look at the video I did on how growers manipulate plants using day length, because that's, again, an indirect way of manipulating these plant growth hormones. All right, I hope you found this brief sort of biological view of how plants regulate their growth. They don't have brains, they just count hormones. And I hope I found that interesting. And if you have any questions, please drop those into the comments below the video.